Lego is the only toy with so many grown men still playing with it. So here's the question, are adult fans of Lego losers? The answer to this question is not a simple yes or a no. So welcome to Unbrick Me, where I unbrick everything in terms of the Lego world. If you want me to uncover more secrets of the Lego cult, make sure to subscribe, leave a comment, and if you leave a comment, you get a shout out. Now, let's continue. There are two ways you could go about to answer the question. First, you could simply look on the surface. If a grown man plays with a children's toy, you might automatically assume that this alone makes him a loser. Well, no. As with anything, you have to look at adult fans of Lego a little more deeply, without first making any assumptions. To properly answer the question presented, we must examine the real-world applications of Lego, the mental health benefits of Lego, and how Lego impacts grown gorillas who have to shave twice a day. One of the most prominent figures who pioneered the fact that Lego could be used in real-world applications is a man by the name of Lawrence Volk. He had an actual robotics engineering background. Lawrence Volk earned a bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering from Delft University of Technology, and he's currently pursuing a master's degree in systems and control. He enjoys doing crazy things, such as integrating Raspberry Pi with his robots. Robots that are built out of Lego! He also actually figured out how to program the Lego Mindstorms EV3 from the browser with Python and EV3 Dev. Simply insane, considering many believe this to be a toy just for kids. He designed many Segway robots out of Lego, and balancing programs are extremely difficult to code, and he even published several robotics books to teach Lego fans all about his passion. He has designed so many robots, Lego Mindstorms RCX, NXT, and EV3 robots. He has designed chimney climbers, Segways, a dog, a mantis, and that's just the tip of the iceberg. I would argue that he alone has shaped the way Lego fans use Mindstorms to this day. Even some universities who teach adult men use Lego as an educational tool. At the Oslo and Akershus University College of Applied Sciences and the Department of Electrical Engineering, a huge bridge-laying robot was built using Lego Mindstorms. The robot utilizes 4 servo motors, 2 linear actuators, 2 ultrasonic sensors, 2 touch sensors, and 2 color sensors to accomplish its task. The robot was programmed in Robot C. You hear that? All this is made with Lego bricks! Lego bricks that were initially designed just to be a little entertaining for small children. Just look at how well the bridge rises. Boom! The robot drops the bridge. And now what? Oh. My. God! The Lego robot is going over the gap with its own bridge, which is made out of Lego. But we're not done yet. The robot turns around, picks up the bridge, and goes on its merry way. And these actions of adult fans of Lego are just the tip of the iceberg. One qualified psychologist, John Sutton, the managing editor of the Psychologist magazine and an adult fan of Lego, has written his own article about Lego, saying how he uses it as a psychological tool for relaxation. In his own words, "What was a little more than a passing interest in my childhood built into something of an obsession when I had my own children, and I should probably abandon the pretense I'm buying it for them." The idea of a Lego cult is in no way exaggerated. Can you believe it? Lego is used by psychologists all across the world as a relaxation tool. That's insane. In the Lego documentary, A Lego Brickumentary, we can see how Dr. Daniel Legoff treats autistic children using Lego as a way to help them collaborate and be more social with each other. The documentary also provides an inside look at how Adrian Pitt, a child who struggled in speech and language, actually got severely benefited by playing with Lego. Think about it. Without adult fans of Lego psychologists, such cool treatments would never exist. But how does this impact you, or the average adult fan of LEGO who isn't a psychologist or a crazy engineer? Most adult fans of LEGO go to LEGO conventions, showing off some of their insane creations that they build on their own, either with LEGO Mindstorms, LEGO Technic, or normal system bricks. In the world of adult fans of LEGO, this toy is used as a tool for people to bond together, to be social, and to interact with each other at all these conventions. Without adult fans of LEGO, such YouTubers such as M&R Productions or Jangbricks would have never existed. Adult fans of LEGO always create mocks, large creations, which no kid can build. I mean, come on, this thing looks absolutely insane. LEGO has even started its own show of LEGO Masters, where primarily the masters who are building these LEGO creations are adult fans of LEGO. This show is even geared towards older fans of LEGO. It's quite unlikely that a child would simply binge watch the entire show. A lot of adult fans of LEGO, average adult fans of LEGO, simply use LEGO as a way to help them relax, because they had a stressful day either with their kids or at work, or just in their life, and they need a place and they need something to help them escape reality. That's why LEGO is so special. So, to answer the original question, no, adult fans of LEGO are not losers. Despite the stereotype of them constantly living in their mom's basement and being just grown kids, they have a lot of potential. They use LEGO as an avenue to help them explore who they really are. And if you are an adult fan of LEGO, and if you embrace your passion of building with a children's toy, then no, you are not a loser. This is Jeremy Breakme here, and I'll see you in the next one.